Hi everybody, it's Mark. We're here again with Let's Talk About Indiana Jones. Disney Collectibles. We all know that Indiana Jones and Disney have gone back a long ways, especially with the Disney opening with Hollywood Studios with the Stunt Spectacular, with the great movie ride having the scene from the Ark of the Covenant in there. Then, of course, the great Disney ride, the adventure ride that went into Disneyland. And then we had, the Temple of Peril in Paris, the Crystal Skull in, not Shanghai, but I think Disney Seas. And then upcoming in Disney Animal Kingdom, the new Indiana Jones adventure ride based on animals, creatures. We'll have to wait and see. But we all have collectibles from Disney that we've gotten. Things that have gotten, t-shirts. Things that, you know, like they even had posters there at one time. They've also had the soundtrack sets from a few years ago. They've had leather jackets. Not so good, not so bad. Some of the jackets that even were like long length ones, like maybe Blade the Vampire would have wore. But yeah, so they had those there. I have collected quite a few things from the parks themselves. I'm not going to be showing them like I've done in the other past videos where I bring something out and I show it and so forth. I'm going to be showing them in pictures and discussing them a little bit through that way. There was just a lot of stuff I got. So as we get on along here, we're going to get to it, and we'll start seeing some of the pictures. We've got the buttons. We've got pins. I bet you didn't even know they came out with a license plate. Anyways, here we go. We'll be right back. Okay, well, as we're getting here, we have the first one of collectible I ever got was the Indiana Jones license plate. This was back in the 90s when I got it. Pretty cool, I always thought. You know, I might pop it on my car, that would be cool. Then the next one was the Indiana Jones lunchbox. Lunchbox basically had, just the main picture from the poster on it. On the sides, it was Indy. Look down there, there's no Marion. Other side, Marion, and then the other side is the same thing as before, an Indy with the clasp or whatever you want to call them. They had the Indiana Jones 3¾ or 4-inch toys. The back showed you all the different figures. I don't know if I'll have a picture here of some of the figures here. I got them all. The Indies, Marions. Then they also came out with the build your metal things. They, as you can see, each one has different settings. They changed them out. The Indiana Jones puzzles based on the magnet art that they came out with a couple years ago. The Indiana Jones Adventure Ride puzzle, 1,000 pieces. They have a Raiders of the Lost Ark puzzle, also 1,000 pieces. Let's see what else they got here. They had the 7-inch, I think there were figures. This is Raiders of the Lost Ark, Indiana Jones. As you can see, it's got Indy in the background there. There's a picture of him loose, along with some other figures. Temple of Doom Indy. Got Temple of Doom Indy head in the background. Well, now they have them released as in Temple of Doom like that, but it's just a brown with a brown shadow. They had car racers. They have a cartoon Indy racer. They have the same car, but in an Indiana Jones with Harrison Ford's face on it. So they do get away with using his face on some of the artwork. They also have the antenna topper, magnets for your car. This was from last year. Pins, some of the newer ones that they came out with, the Indy. There's a figure set. They also changed the box on that lately. So it's now it's brown with just a set of Indiana Jones at the bottom. It's a brown character silhouette, Mickey Mouse bank. With the Mickey Mouse stuffed toy right next to it. We have the Mickey Mouse. This is the second in a series of statues that they made. There's another one where Indy's holding the idol. This one, you get the bag with the idol in it. There's Indiana Jones Mickey Mouse figures. Goofy as Sala, Mickey as Indy, and then you have them connected together in a little box set. There's a popcorn bucket they had for the Indiana Jones Hollywood Studios Stunt Spectacular. Got two of those. Those are pretty cool. They also sell torches at some of the shops now. You can pick them up. And they also have what was online and still in the parks. They have the Idol, the Staff of Ra Medallion. They have the Sankara stones, which light up. I wish I would have had the video to have them light up. Maybe in a future video. The Cup of Christ, or chalice, if you want to call it, from The Last Crusade. That's also from Disney. They also have the alien skull from the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. Lights up also. They just have from Temple of Doom, they have the voodoo doll, and just released was the Indiana Jones Grail tablet. Here is a rubber sword from Temple of, Indiana Jones, basically. They have a whip, kind of like...
whip from the park.
It's cool. It's just that it's, looking, you know, got a little name tag with it. Price is $50. Also looks like about two, maybe three pliets.
Price of $50 and an Indiana Jones
name tag, I guess, as you can see. So that is something that I wasn't really going to get, but I had a few extra dollars floating around the last time I went down to Disney. And then everybody knows they have Disney press machines. They have the press machines that make the pennies and look spectacular on it. So that's pretty cool stuff.
So that was some of the stuff that I have of the Indiana Jones products. If something that I know, the G.I. Joe figures were something that everybody always looks forward to. I never got those. There was a black G.I. Joe action figure or African-American and the Caucasian or the white G.I. Joe. They had them both available. I remember they were being around $80 when they first came out. You can find them on eBay sometimes. They're quite expensive. Other than there's a lot of pins that they have available from the parks. I do have quite a bit. I could show you a few of them, point them out though. But these are the pins that I have from the Disney parks. Okay, so the pins that I got from the Disney parks, I have this one. Those are two of the newest ones. That is an old one there. That one. Disney Apparel from Paris. Adventure Ride. 25th anniversary is up here. Disney pin there. Mickey Mouse and the Stunt Spectacular. There's quite a bit. Temples. Some anniversary pins up here for it. Disney pin again for the Staff of Ra. Also joined some of my other ones. Here's another Indiana Jones from the ride. Indy Moves. So there's a lot of different ones that are available. I'm still trying to figure out what else I have. I know that I'm probably missing something. That's, like I said, there was just some of the stuff that I got. Just having the fun of going to see Indiana Jones at the parks was always something fun for me. Like I said, you know, we've always gotten shirts. This is the sweatshirt for Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom from Disney. They came out with t-shirts for each of the movies with the movie posters, some artwork, some hard to find shirts nowadays, especially when A Dial of Destiny came out. They had one, you know, kind of a one special one for Disney at the Disneyland parks last year. If I can find more, I'll show some more later at a later date. If you guys have ideas of something else to talk about, let me know. I know that you get quite a bit of different things going on right now. that you would like to see. But yeah, so it's kind of an adventure collecting all this stuff. And I don't know if you've seen some of the stuff I've seen posted before. I'm still rearranging my room a little bit, trying to get things sorted. I've got comic boxes here that I have to get rid of. They're full of art, blank comic books. If you're interested in seeing a video of some of those, I can show you those too. But it's not going to be under the Indiana Jones Let's Talk banner. But yeah, so until we meet again here, let's have a good adventure, and we'll talk to you real soon. Take care.